Regional equities trading lower following a negative lead from Wall Street overnight. All three major U.S. indices closed Monday's lower. Concerns, of course, are the U.S. Fed, which may not cut rates as much as expected. Taking a look now at major stock indices in Asia, Chinese markets are up after Chinese regulators vowed to, quote, guide institutional investors to enter the market with greater efforts following a recent sell-off. In the land down under, the ASX 200 closes in the red as investors examine Australia's latest monetary policy decision. Canberra's central bank held rates steady on Tuesday as expected, but it cautioned a further increase could not be ruled out given inflation was still too high. Taking a look now at futures in Europe, they are pointing to a rebound after a lackluster trade on Monday, still dominated by rate cut discussions. Now investors in the region will be on watch for construction and retail sales, which are coming out of the Eurozone. Stateside now, futures are flat with the focus on several central bank officials that slated to speak today. Denise Insay now joins us on the program to provide the latest on the ongoing push to amend the Constitution. Hi, Denise.
Hi, Stanley. Now, two former Senate presidents urging President Marcos to end the worsening rift between the two houses of Congress over charter change. Franklin De Leon says someone outside of Congress should mediate between the Senate and the lower house. De Leon adds the conflict does not serve public interest. Tito Soto also believes only President Marcos can end the rift. De Leon and Soto now calling on both chambers of Congress to hold a dialogue to thresh out their issues. On Monday, the House of Representatives issued a resolution condemning what it calls the Senate's attacks on House Speaker Martin Romualdez and the People's Initiative for Charter Change. Some corporate stories today. Panasonic Manufacturing resumes operations at its facility in Santa Rosa in Laguna. This came 2 months after it halted the production of electric fans in the factory due to a fire. It's also resuming the sale of these fans and the production of its washing machine units by March. Meanwhile, coconut products exporter Axelum lays out initiatives for long-term growth. The firm says it will maximize distributorship's third-party brokers and physical presence to expand global reach. Axelum will also reintroduce existing products and develop incubator projects to tap the potential of its consumer segment. The company recently got a 5.3 billion peso boost from Metro Pacific Agro Ventures. The agriculture arm of Metro Pacific Investments secured a 34.76% equity stake in Axelum following the undertaking. Meanwhile, Philippine Senator Risa Ontiveros calls for an investigation into the recent major cyber attack attempts on government websites. The Information and Communications Technology Department has confirmed cyber criminals targeted websites of the Philippine Coast Guard, Justice Department, the House of Representatives, as well as President Marcos's personal website. But it clarified there's no concrete evidence linking the Chinese government to the hacking attempts. Ontiveros has filed a resolution seeking an inquiry into the matter. The senator says instead of focusing on charter change that will only benefit some people, Congress should focus on strengthening laws to ensure national security.
The Philippine Transportation Department sets aside 14 billion pesos for the development and modernization of some 20 airports across the country. These include airports in Catbalogan, Tacloban, Lawag, Puerto Princesa, Calibo, and Iloilo. Now, the DOTR says several other airports are being developed also under the Marcos administration's public-private partnership scheme. Meanwhile, the agency is seeking funding for its long-delayed Mindanao Railway project after China withdrew its financial commitment. The DOTR is already in talks with the finance department to look for funds from other foreign governments and international financial institutions. The proposed railway system aims to connect key provinces down south and further enhance Mindanao's economy. A global index on passport openness ranks the Philippine travel document at 17th place this year. Manila stood at the said spot out of 199 countries. In the 2024 edition of the report by Henley and Partners, now this measures the number of nationalities that countries and territories permit to entry to without a prior visa. Now, the Philippines previously faced or placed 73rd in the Henley Index, measuring the world's most powerful passports. Moving on for numbers that matter, today it's 73 billion pesos. This was the Customs Bureau's revenue collection in the first month of 2024, which was higher by 1.5 billion. That's its target of 71.7 billion. It's also an improvement by nearly 4% from its collection in the same period last year. The agency says the better system of determining customs value of imported goods, as well as tighter border collection, among others, had helped push collections up. Customs officials are upbeat on maintaining the higher collections this year. The agency says this will help contribute to the economy and will show its commitment to fiscal responsibility.